Ruchi and Kiara, from me, Hrishi K, and everybody who's watching and listening, thank you for doing this interview.
Thank you for having me.
So St. Martin sounds ridiculously close to St. Stephen's College in Delhi. I mean, it looks like St. Stephen's College. And, you know, they also have a Founders Day. I mean, it's actually a compliment.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
So I just want to get that straight. The Founders Day thing. Did you go to St. Stephen's?
I actually am the only person in my entire family who hasn't been to Stephen's.
But in fact,
when it was funny when we went for the recce, and we were going in some of the classrooms. They have those old, you know, like the first year. And I was looking at one of them, I was like, oh my God, that's my great grand uncle. Yeah.
And they don't even call it their canteen or their cafeteria. They call it their, what do they call it?
The cafe.
And the hostel is called the residence.
Residence.
Yeah.
It's like very cool. Yeah. It's like a Karan Johar film.
We shot in many of the colleges in DU, actually.
Great. Kiara, sometimes the cool ones or the so-called rock chicas, as it were, quote-unquote, are actually the ones who are the most emotional. I mean, they look really carefree, but then if you scratch under the surface that, you know, they actually put up a facade because they don't want to get hurt. And they're actually deep down really mushy and emotional. Do you agree with that?
You're bang on, right? Because the character Nanki that I play, the reason for her to look like this, you know, this badass girl with her tattoos and her hair color and her piercings, it's actually her armor. It's her mask that she's using to protect herself and protect that inner fragility from letting anyone come close to that or knowing what she's really hiding. So it is something that she is hiding. And I think that, like, for me, what was most exciting was when Ruchi came up with the look of the character. She explained to me why she has these tattoos and why she decided to color her hair from this to this. There was, you know, there's so many layers that there was so much backstory that you will see in the film as we go, you will, each layer will be unveiled. But that was so interesting to see on screen a character who looks so rebellious, and then you find out why they are like that. So I think it's exciting, and it's also liberating, because when you put on this tough exterior, inside they're so fragile, and it's literally like a trigger, and you're like, but why is she behaving like this?
Especially in college, because, you know, as it is, men are boys.
Yeah.
And in college, they are even younger, mentally.
Yeah.
And they always think that these are the girls who are easy. Mm. So you've got to, you know.
Yeah, tough enough, and look like that.
So the thing about entitled boys, and I say this because the little bit that we've seen, there's this thing about entitled people. And the thing about them is that they're wealthy public school boys. They're very well scrubbed and things like that. But they also have a bit of a chip on their shoulder. I know a few like that. Do you know a few like that?
I frankly don't know any person who doesn't have some chip on their shoulder.
Yeah.
Whether they're boys or girls or men or women. I have a firm belief that every single person is flawed, and that definitely will come across in the film, because I also feel that's what makes them real and relatable. And I want to explore and not hide away from this, because, you know, everyone has their story, everyone has their background, their reasons of why they are a certain way. And I feel as a race, if we try to empathize and understand each other more, we are far more likely to make for a better society than judge people guilty for one aspect of their personality.
So it's interesting you would say that. So you're saying, as opposed to saying that he's from Doon, she's from Wellham, she's from Mayo, you know, public school types, we just need to look at people as people.
Yeah, that's
an interesting thought. Have you ever lined up in a girl's hostel like you did in this? It's quite cool. You're lining up for a bath. Have you ever been in a hostel? I mean, have you lived alone?
I went to college in Mumbai, where I've been born and brought up. So I never had that hostel life. But of course, when we used to go on like school trips and things like that, then it was like that, right?
It's camping.
Yeah, we're camping out. We used to have those trips. We'd go on these camps, stay in jungles, do all of that. And it's actually so much fun. You know, and in this film especially, because there are a lot of scenes where you see them in the hostel and how they are. There's even a very interesting relationship that they share with the
chai boy.
With yeah, whether it's the chai boy or whether it's the Pramila ma'am.
Oh yeah, the warden.
The warden.
Yeah.
Every single, you become like a family because you're, you know, that's away from home, and sometimes you become so dependent on each other, and there's a certain system that you have, and it's so interesting because it's the way we've captured it in the film is really as is, how the girls come, very typically, you know, you're washing your own clothes. It's a lot of fun, and I think I thoroughly enjoyed it while we were.
I mean, I'm a hostelite. I've been to boarding school, and I've also stayed in the hostel here in Bombay at Savitri Devi.
Oh, the legendary Savitri Devi.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. It's
all of us boys
legendary.
Used to hang outside.
Yeah. So. I know.
And the other one in Marine Drive, what is it called? Oh my God,
That's the one.
There's one near opposite YB Chavan also. There's another working women's
That's
hostel.
Cooperage. Yeah.
Sorry.
So we know where he was hanging out.
No, but it is typical. Like in the hostel, in Marine Drive hostel, like at late at night, cars would drive by or some boy would
sneak out of the hostel.
Okay, aajao. And I would just be like, so what do they think? They just say, come down and someone will come. Like,
you'll be surprised that a few we did come down. But I'm just saying, anyway. So I find Akanksha's character really interesting. I mean, she's a small town girl. She tells lies some of the time to get ahead. I mean, it's kind of like that story, you know, of the girl who kept crying wolf, and one fine day the wolf came and nobody believed her. So I want to know what was in your mind when you were writing this part and then casting this part.
When I was I mean, the way I wanted to design Tanu was that she is very upfront. Like what I told Akanksha also when she was playing the character, is that everyone is going to think you are a gold digger. But in your mind, you are the gold. So you don't have to dig for anything. Yeah. He should be lucky if you look at him. That is how you think. Yeah. So that was my idea of Tanu, which is, I would say it's pretty much the most fantastical character because like 99.99999% of women never think like that.
Yeah, about themselves. So Karan Johar and you have this bond. Is it the Sindhi connection?
Oh, damn, you caught us. We thought no one would ever know that. We thought it was our deepest secret.
Or is it the whole love stories, dharma, and this and that? I mean, it's like that, you know. I'm from the South. So just like Madrasis are clans, so are Sindhi. There's no harm in admitting it. So. Just saying. But yeah, you know, that's the best marketing ambassador anybody could have. It's always Kiara, and Kiara's lovely, and this and that is so special. So the bond that the two of you have.
I have so much respect for him. He discovered me in Love Stories, and ever since has given me films and paths like Monica in Good News, Nanki in Guilty, and then my coming another film that I have with Dharma Productions called Shirsha. And each film has given me an opportunity to play a character that I mean, it's just so exciting to do something so different that nobody really was expecting from me. So it was really funny because yesterday, we had a screening and I was talking to Karan because he's not in Mumbai right now. And another filmmaker who came for our screening had sent him a message. How, you mean after Love Stories, now this, how have you seen this? How have you known this talent exists like this? And he sent it to me and he's like, they're loving it. And I was just like, you know, fingers crossed, we're hoping we get that as well for the, once it's on Netflix. So he's just always been a well-wisher ever since Love Stories. He's had my back. And like you said, I do feel lucky about that. I feel somewhere really safe that someone like him has put in that faith and belief in me. So now I also feel like I really hope to live up to that.
Of course you are. You're already doing it. Ankur Tiwari's done such a great job. I mean, I heard the song, I saw the video, and she's done such a great job. You know, she's a little coy and shy. This guy's serenading her.
Yeah, that's the only part of the film.
It's just so cool. And I actually texted Tiwari saying, man, wow, what a song. So have you guys worked together? Have you collaborated
before? Actually, I'm a fan. I yeah. love his music because, you know, these days, of course, there's so much music always coming out, but I feel he has so much melody and a heartfelt melody inside him. So that's why I wanted, you know, I asked him if he'd do this film. And
so you've never collaborated before, this is the first time.
Yeah.
Wow, that's great. It's a great first time.
Yeah. And he really got the film.
He really understood it. And he understood that, okay, it's a band in today's time. Because, you know, in the script, you just Delhi, you write rock band. So we discussed, well, what kind of music will they play? Because firstly, who listens to rock anymore? Nobody does that.
It's all about opening the MacBooks and making electronic
music. Yeah. So we spoke deeply about it. And in fact, Ankur also, he said, okay, it's going to be this electro rock kind of space. And he had a very good reason for it. And he said, you know, the technology exists now. And he said, I'm 100% sure if the Beatles existed today, they would make electro rock. Because that's what is there, and musicians want to experiment and play with stuff, and that's what they're doing, they're playing.
I just love your styling, the ripped jeans, the red hair. Who styled the film?
Ruchi Narain.
Cuba Sayed. She's amazing.
She's really got that character bang on. And then, you know, Ruchi's inputs on every single tattoo that she dug out from the internet and decided what she wanted on my body, the hair, everything. I mean, for me, initially, it was a bit of a shocker, like, you want me to wear these tattoos, and then you want
and
my hair white, and you want that septum ring in the middle. I was like, that's a lot of hair and makeup in the body, guys. But, you know, it's funny, because the minute I would get into that, I was just Nanki.
Even your body language is like loose.
It's if you just wear clothes, then it looks like a costume. But I have to, again, it's so different from who Kiara is. But she just owned that whole character so well. And she carried the clothes. So, you know, otherwise it would have drawn attention to itself, but it doesn't.
Correct.
You pay attention.
It's become part of her skin.
Her.
Yeah, that's what you mean. And I know exactly what you're saying. But she's old school. She writes in a diary. How cool is that? Everybody's just writing in laptops.
Yeah.
You know, it's so cool. So,
but I also do. But I don't have a diary like a journal. But sometimes I do. Like I have a diary, which I don't write in every day. But sometimes, like, I've got my bucket list, my wish list of directors. I've taken off a few. I've got 30 things I want to do before 30. All of that is happening. And I think it's kind of nice.
So it's not just Nanki, but Kiara writes. You write pen and...
No, not like Nanki. I mean, she writes beautifully. And on that note, I'd like to even mention Kausar, who's written you know, the lyrics.
Yeah.
And it's been a collaborative effort. And he's he plays quite an important part in the film as well. And it's so subtly done because, you know, her outlet is actually her lyrics. And whatever she really wants to say is there. And it comes through so subtly. So she may be telling you one thing, but what she's really feeling is what she's written. The confusion comes when you hear her songs or you see what she's written. And it's quite interesting the way, you know, everything has come together because it's not like a musical. It's not a film where you have a song like that. But it's such a big part of the story and it's so seamlessly integrated in the film that it was...
Yeah, and I love the graffiti in the loose. How many times have men at least, I don't know about girls loose, I haven't been there as yet, but I'm just saying, how many times have I gone into a loo and seen graffiti?
Yeah.
Was such a cool touch.
But I have to tell you, even for the graffiti, because it was Nanki writing, I called Kausar and I said, what would she write? And she's like, okay, I'm going to give you this line and I just want you to know it's because I love you and I love the film because I can make a whole song on this thought. And then she gave me the line, ke, main wo nahi jo dikhti hoon, main wo hoon jo likhti hoon. That's what she wrote.
Yeah. So, I mean, no disrespect to Gulfateh and Tahir, they're wonderful boys, but why do you not have a mainstream hero? You have a mainstream heroine, you have Kiara Advani. Why didn't you have a mainstream hero in those parts, or did you purposely go out casting the new boys?
No, we were very clear that we wanted to cast for the role.
Especially Gulfateh's role, I wanted a fresh...
Definitely.
Because in fact, had baggage.
We said if we want any established actor, he has to do the role of the lawyer. Because if you cast a known person, this was my perspective, if you cast a known perspective in Gurfateh's role, who plays the accused, then I feel the audience will kind may figure out
the end.
So I was very sure that his role has to be a new person. So then, you know, when we spoke, and we decided then it's better if we just have everyone who's not that established, except Nanki.
Fair enough.
And Kiara.
So the whole thing about being guilty or not and having different perspectives on what the truth is, does that happen to you often? Do people say, oh, but Kiara's like this, and you're actually not like that, like judgmental people? And I just don't mean on your social media timeline, even otherwise. I mean, are you often misrepresented? I mean, people get you some other way. Yeah?
I think I'm someone who really can't lie, so everything's on my face. It's not happened too many times, but what does happen is self-judgment sometimes. Mm. When we kind of question, I think we're all constantly apologetic for the things we do and say. And sometimes we don't really need to be, you know. You don't need to be apologetic about your lows and your failures and, you know, your issues and problems. It's fine. It's fine to be honest. It's fine to be flawed. It's fine to be imperfect. And that is something that I took away from this as well.
So the big question, why are you doing such few films? I mean, everybody says, Sudhir Mishra, I remember the first time he talked to you years ago, talented girl, I mean, talented Ruchi. So there's Hanuman Damdar, there's Kal, and there's this one now. So why is your filmography not more than this?
I would love to ask the same question, because it's not like I haven't had scripts or I haven't been out there trying to make things happen. But they just haven't happened at the rate where I feel they should have happened. And, you know, there's a sense of unfairness in that, which actually made me end up writing this film, which is actually about unfairness and inequality.
And it's the business's loss. I'm sure Kiara would agree with me.
No, absolutely. I'm like waiting.
It is,
Already been asking her, what are you working on?
That's so what were you like in college or junior college? I mean, when you look back
so
at that version.
It's because I really wish I was a rebellious kid. But I was just so not. And every time Ruchi would tell me stuff that they would do and the things which are in the film, and I was like, wow, I was quite a damn nerd, man. I mean, my parents really brainwashed me to be this goody-goody image. I was a front bencher. I mean, the worst things I've done is like bunking classes and, you know, that kind of stuff. But the badass stuff, none. I don't think it's in my DNA, so I really did have to portray this character, Nanki, and change the wiring that I know how it works within me.
Why is she in the hospital? I mean, is she a non-Delhiite in the film?
Yeah.
Is Nanki?
Yes, she's an artist.
Okay. You're carrying films on your shoulders now. I mean, there's a solo poster saying Guilty, Kiara, with the Kabir Singh and the Good News and all these films doing so well. Do you feel validated, or do you have to remind yourself of your struggling days when you gave auditions?
Well, I'll never forget those days. Those days make me who I am, and I should never forget those. That's why I keep reminding myself. I used to always look for validation from other people. I still will always look for validation from my directors, but I think now I've come to a point where, and maybe it happened after Kabir Singh, where I felt like what's most important is self-validation. And if you can finally look at them, because we're so critical of ourselves all the time. I'm always like, what do you think, what do you think, what do you think? And I'm always believing things that I'm depending on everybody else's, you know, perception of me. And now it's time that I feel like I need to have my own opinion. So I feel this is my coming into my own as well.
Sweet. She's also a character, Nanki, who doesn't take bullshit. I love, you were so like bits and pieces of the film.
Yeah.
I love the fact, the scene where she's in the car and, you know, she just tells him off. And, you know, she says, you watch it, because he accuses her of flirting and things like that. And that must mean so awesome, you know, to have somebody who kicks butt like that. You know?
But it's also so real. I
it is,
like it's something all of us would have done, like a girlfriend and a boyfriend sitting in that moment, and you accuse each other of these kind of things, and it just felt like such a real conversation, even when we were shooting it. Mm. So that's actually one of my favorite scenes.
It's one of my favorite scenes. Yeah.
I love the character actors. This Kunal Vijaykar, my friend, and the lady who plays the warden. Who's she? I mean, I've never seen
Renuka. Yes. We cast her from Delhi. So.
Wow. Yeah. And do you know Tahir from when he was assisting Sudhir?
Is that? Yeah, of course.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Okay. My last question is International Women's Day. A woman that you deeply admire. It could be your friend, family circle, or just be somebody in the public eye. And why you find them so inspiring on Women's Day. Mm. So I'd like both of you to take that.
Oh, that's really a hard one.
Yeah, it is.
Because there are many.
You can mention a few strong, inspiring women. Yeah.
Like, okay, I'll just mention Meera Nair, actually. Because also she's a director, and she was a director at a time when there weren't that many. It's not like she was the only one, but there were hardly any. And why I love her as a filmmaker. I think she's a supreme filmmaker, a really good director who understands people. But also because I've met her in person.
She's feisty.
And I also know a lot of my friends who assisted her. So I hear stories about her as their boss.
Wow.
And I've met her as a person. She is so warm. And she always, you can be an assistant. When I met her, I was an assistant. She'll come and sit next to you and she'll make sure that, she's at your level. She puts you at ease, and she wants you to come out, and she wants to know who are you, what are you, what is your story. She engages with you so warmly, and I know stories of her as a boss, and she is really the best boss, or as Zoya calls her, film mommy ever. Though she wasn't my film mama, she's an amazing person and one woman who shaped me, actually, who I do want to talk about is Renu Saluja. She was an editor and she was Sudhir's partner. So when I actually assisted Sudhir, I didn't have that much interaction with him, actually. It was Renu who I actually learned my craft from. And she was the editor. And because I was just hungry to learn, I used to sit with her. I said, can I come to your editing room? I sit behind her. She would edit. And, she would, if I by mistake said something, but why can't you do this? Instead of telling me to A, shut up, or B, say, it won't work, she would do what I've said and show me so that I could understand.
How beautiful.
Exactly. She was such a senior person. All the directors were working with her at that time, and all people used to graduate from FTII and then come and assist her. But she was so down to earth and humble, and she was such a great sharer. And
nurturer, yeah.
Everyone who worked with her is, she touched so many people's lives. And frankly, she taught me craft, and I feel she really shaped those films that she worked on. And after she passed away, none of those filmmakers ever had the same finesse in their
films. Beautiful answer. A woman or women who shaped you? Last one.
To be really honest, my grandmom, Valerie Solvay, I know she's going to watch this for sure. I think she's just someone she's had a very difficult life. And she's someone who never ever shows that. She's just someone who's happy. She's 70 and she's driving, working, coming to meet us, taking care of things. I mean, I just see her and I'm like, when I'm 70, I want to be her. So for me, my grandmom's like the ultimate diva at home, and she's somebody I look up to. And I mean, I just feel if I can be half the woman that she is eventually, I would be proud of my life.
And there's so many girls who want to be the next Ruchi or the next Kiara. Thank you very much. I had a wonderful time talking to you.
Thank you so
and
much.
I can't wait to see the full film.
Yeah, we can't wait for you to watch it. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.